Hello everyone. Learn Python an easier way. This video tutorial is designed for people who wants to learn Python programming language from scratch. So you must have heard about all these things in the Python community. We'll see some of the terms in this video. According to the latest TIOB programming community index, Python is one of the top 5 popular programming languages of 2020. Google Trends interest over time shows that among the three languages, Python, R and Julia, there is a constant increase in the Python users over the last 5 years. So we can see that people starts using Python for so many reasons. So what is Python and what can it do? Python is a general purpose and high level programming language, interpreted, interactive and object oriented scripting language. You can use Python for developing desktop GUI applications, websites and web applications. Using Python, you can focus on core functionality of the application by taking the care of common programming tasks. It is derived from many programming languages like ABC, Modular 3, C, C++, Algol 68, Smalltalk, Unix Shell and other scripting languages. So what can it do? So Python can be used on a server to create web applications. It can connect to database systems. It can also read and modify files. Python can be used to handle big data and perform complex mathematics. It can be used for rapid prototyping or for production ready software development. So why Python? Python has few keywords, simple structure and clearly defined syntax. This allows the people to pick up the language quickly. It is easy to read. It was designed for readability and has some similarities to the English language. It uses English keywords frequently, whereas other programming languages use punctuation and it has fewer syntactical construction than other languages. Python code is more clearly defined. Python source code is fairly easy to maintain. Python runs on an interpreter system, meaning that the code can be executed as soon as it is written. This means prototyping can be very quick. It is portable. Python works on different platforms, Windows, Mac, Linux, Raspberry Pi, etc. and has the same interface on all platforms. It is embeddable. You can easily place your Python code in non-Python programs. It is extendable. You can add low-level modules to Python interpreter. These modules enable programmers to add or customize their tools to be more efficient. It can easily be integrated with C, C++, ActiveX, Corba, and Java. The strength of Python is the packages it supports. This is a list of worldwide Python users. Python programming language is widely used by companies around the world to build web apps, analyze data, automate operations, create reliable, scalable enterprise applications. The programming language is currently being used by a number of high-traffic websites including Google, Yahoo Groups, Yahoo Maps, Linux Weekly News, Shopzilla, and Web Therapy. Likewise, Python also finds greater use for creating gaming, financial, scientific, and educational applications. Many companies do not even realize they are using Python across their organizations. For example, if a company is a Java-only shop, but they use IBM WebSphere as a web application server, then they have to use Python to script the server's configuration. Python has a habit of getting into everywhere, regardless of whether the usage is intentional. So, rest of the organizations, you can use this link to find out. Evolution of Python. Python was originally developed by Guido van Rossum as a hobby project in December 1989. Python was originally designed to be a successor of ABC programming language. After writing the interpreter, von Rosum made the code public in February 1991. However, at present, the open source programming language is being managed by Python Software Foundation. Python 4.0 is expected to be available in 2023 after the release of Python 3.9. Getting Python. Python is copyrighted. Python source code is now available under the GNU General Public License, GPL. The most up-to-date and current source code, binaries, documentation, news, etc. is available on the official website of Python, http://www.python.org. You can also download the documentation from the doc folder. The documentation is available in HTML, PDF and PostScript formats. There are some free books available. I have just named very few. You have a package or standard library for so many fields, for machine learning, GUI applications, web frameworks, image processing, web scraping, etc. So a package in Python takes the concept of modular approach to the next logical level. So a module can contain multiple objects such as classes and functions. A package can contain one or more relevant modules. Physically, a package is actually a folder containing one or more module files. We have Python libraries and some frameworks. A framework is a platform for developing software applications. It provides a foundation on which software developers can build programs for a specific platform. For example, you have a deep learning frameworks. So these are all the frameworks you can use it for deep learning applications. Similarly, for web related frameworks, you have Beautiful Soup, Flask or Django. These are some of the packages that are available. So as I said, these are all the Python frameworks, Django, Flask. How do you install Python? Python distribution is available for a wide variety of platforms. You need to download only the binary code applicable for your platform and install Python. If it is Microsoft Windows, you have to install Python for Windows. Or it is Mac, you have to download the corresponding binary downloader. So now we have seen Python IDE. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. It is basically a software pack that consists of the equipments which are used for developing and testing the software. An IDE understands your code much better than a text editor. It usually provides features such as build automation, testing, and debugging. This can significantly speed up your work. There are so many IDEs available. The main thing is IDLE. It will be automatically installed by default. Its major features include Python shell window, auto completion, syntax highlighting, smart indentation, and basic integrated debugger. PyCharm. PyCharm provides a major features that a good IDE should provide: code completion, code inspecting, error highlighting and fixes, debugging, version control system, and code refactoring. You have Visual Studio Code is a free and open source IDE created by Microsoft that can be used for Python environment. Then you have Anaconda. Anaconda is free and can be installed on computers without any administrative rights. Anaconda comes bundled with about 600 packages pre-installed, including NumPy, Matplotlib, and SymPy. These three packages are very useful for problem solvers and will be discussed in subsequent videos. You have Jupyter Notebook. It is an application that runs Python code, display plots, show equations, and contain formatted text. Jupyter Notebooks are a great tool for problem solvers to write, run, and document and share Python code with others. We'll now just see different IDEs. So the first two IDEs are from IDLE, IDLE. This is the command interpreter where you can type in the commands, it will get executed. Suppose you want to write a program, then you can use this file menu and then create a file and you can run it. So the output of this file will be stored, will be shown in this shell window. This is an example for PyCharm. Now I just show you how to download Anaconda. The first thing is you have to download the Anaconda installer. Either you go to Google and type Anaconda Python. You have this individual edition Anaconda, or you can use this link to go to the Anaconda URL. The second step will be download the Anaconda installer. So when you type in this URL at the browser, you get a screen like this. Then you have to click this download button. When you click the download button, you get these options, whether you want to install it for Windows or Mac OS or Linux. So it is based on your system you have. So here I have downloaded the 64-bit graphical installer for Windows. So it is asking you to store the directory. Now it's been saved. Then you have to double click the installer to launch. So once you will have some options to select, and once everything is over, when you give the finish, this Anaconda will be installed. Now your screen will be like this. So you have to click the Anaconda Navigator. You get something like this. You will have this initialization carried on. Then you get a screen like this. In this screen, as I have told you, you have a Jupyter Notebook. You have to launch the Jupyter Notebook. So this is the screen of the Jupyter Notebook. You can select already available programs, or you can create a new Python notebook. So I'm going to show you how this Jupyter Notebook will be. I'm just launching it here. When I launch it, it will be launched in a browser. So it can be a Google Chrome or a Firefox. So here you can see that it is loaded in localhost 888, and these are all available directories. So these are all some of the notebooks I am using. Here the extension of that notebook will be IPYNB. So these are all the notebooks. If I want to create a notebook, I have to click new. And then I have to select this Python 3. So the notebook is getting loaded. You have code window. So here I can just type whatever code I want to say. Then to execute that, I can just give shift enter. So I am printing this A, shift enter. So I get the answer. This is how we are going to do that. We can also have text window also. Here I can select this code and I can give a markdown. I can say is a code window. So here if I want to make it as a heading, I can just make it. I can keep typing that. Once I type the code, I have to give shift enter. Hope you have understood how to install Anaconda and work with